When it comes to securing your financial future, no one has more responsibility over the outcome than you do. So today, I want to share on this video a couple of ideas for how to grow your wealth in the coming year. If you're a subscribed member of my community, then welcome back. And if you're not, consider subscribing right now. All right, now I'd like to thank my video sponsor, Blue Lagoon Resources. They're a great company, and I'll tell you more about them later in the video. Okay, now for many months, I've been letting my community know about stimulus checks and also stimulus packages. Because of Congress's inability to come together on a package that stimulates the economy and gets it back on track, over 15 million Americans still find themselves out of work. We are at a crossroad as Americans. If the U.S. doesn't do enough stimulus, we could see the country and the economy slip into a recession, or worse, a second Great Recession. If they do too much, we could see the devaluation of the U.S. dollar while inflation raises the price of food and other items we buy on a daily basis. So 2021 is going to be a different year when it comes to investing, when it comes to how you think about your money. The U.S. economy is still in a desperate need for stimulus. Headlines in the media say things like 2021 could be a rough year for the U.S. It also says things like Joe Biden is saying we could have a dark winter and a difficult year. To say that things could be bleak in 2021 would be an understatement. Now, the Trump administration has seen a V-shaped recovery, but mostly with companies that can survive the lockdown. What they've essentially created is a K-shaped recovery, where a few thrive and the majority are victimized by restrictions and layoffs. Meanwhile, to survive closing down and shutting big parts of the economy off, the U.S. government had to add nearly $5 trillion to the national debt in less than 1 year, with the potential for even more money needed to help the U.S. economy avoid another Great Depression. So in this video, I want to share what could be the best way to beat inflation, protect your money, and see it grow in 2021. What if I told you that the two biggest names in investing are now jumping into precious metals as a way of growing their company portfolios in what could be a weird 2021 economic rebound? For example, big hedge fund manager Ray Dalio, who is worth $17 billion, has been preoccupied with worry about inflation as the federal government and the Federal Reserve Bank take on massive amounts of debt with no real plan for how they'll ever pay this debt down. In his book, he lays out a solid investing future, and I was shocked to see how much he believes in owning gold and silver and other precious metals. Plus, Paul Singer, another hedge fund titan, has called gold the last undervalued asset class in the world. Both Goldman Sachs and Wells Fargo Bank analysts have forecasted that gold could hit $2,300 an ounce in 2021. Now, in the spring of 2020, the stock market dropped by double-digit numbers. Maybe you were affected, or maybe you didn't have any market drop because you weren't in the market. Some areas of the economy have rebounded nicely, while others are still trying to find their new normal. Around this time, world-famous investor Warren Buffett, who is worth $87 billion, sold off his entire portfolio of Delta stock. Now, that hurt me personally, and I told you about that in a separate video. But now, Warren Buffett, who has been a huge fan of commodity stocks and not a fan of gold, suddenly did a 180. Earlier this year, Warren Buffett was converted to gold and started investing in gold mining stock companies. So why did Warren Buffett suddenly drop most of his airline stocks and then go on to divest himself of many of his large bank holdings? What is he seeing about the future that we aren't seeing? Why would Warren Buffett start buying gold mining stocks? Why would Ray Dalio buy gold and other precious metals? Why is Ray Dalio's biggest fear inflation and the shrinking value of the US dollar? Again, what is it that they are seeing that you and I are not? Now, you don't become a billionaire or a world-famous investor like these two without astute insight and profound knowledge on inflation and also on monetary policy. While the stimulus the government has been willing to pass has been helpful to millions and millions of Americans, it has weakened the dollar, which is trading at a five-year low. And it has given serious rise to worries about inflation in the future. Essentially, as the government prints more money, the US dollar has less value and less buying power. Remember when the lockdown first started and all of a sudden we saw spikes in the price of food? This is what I'm talking about, but on an ongoing basis. What I think Warren Buffett's Berkshire Hathaway has figured out is not to own the gold, but to own the mines that develop gold projects for the coming years. I think Warren Buffett wants to invest in gold producers and not the gold directly, okay? So he doesn't want to find the goose that lays the golden egg so that he can have the egg. He wants the actual goose that lays golden eggs over and over and over again. Now, the median cost of pulling gold out of the earth is $975 an ounce, while the open market price is nearly double that. So as of right now, gold mining has very healthy margins and the potential for good upside in the future. So how do you and I protect our money against losing buying power and value over time? This is where gold and silver being a part of your portfolio makes a lot of sense. So for example, let's say that 100 years ago, you buried $20 worth of gold and your neighbor buried $20 worth of paper money. That gold today would be worth $1,840, while that paper money would still be worth $20. I share this so that you can see that the gold coin didn't change, but its value changed drastically from $20 to $1,840 in a 100-year period. Okay. Meanwhile, the paper money actually lost value and lost buying power. That $20 does not buy the same amount of goods and services today as it did 100 years ago. And you may not know this, but in 2008, during the Great Recession, the price of gold was $972 an ounce. Today, that same gold is valued at $1,840 an ounce. It's crazy how much it's gone up since the Great Recession. Now, the price of gold does go up and down. It fluctuates like other assets, but over time, it always trends in a positive direction, right? So given enough time, it will go in a positive direction. In fact, Goldman Sachs and Wells Fargo reported that the price of gold could be around $2,300 an ounce by the end of 2021. And Bank of America's analysts recently came out with a target price of 2063. So there's still quite a bit of upside potential just in the next 12 months. Now, overall, many people, wealthy people, either own gold or silver as some percentage of their overall portfolio, maybe not their entire portfolio, since it provides a great hedge against currencies devaluation. In the past 20 years, gold has been a top performing asset, rising by 700% since the year 2000, which is higher than the S&P 500 and the NASDAQ. So, how do you take advantage of gold and grow your money without having to have rooms full of gold at your house? Because storing it is the hard part. Spending it is the hard part, but you need the value, the physical gold behind it, to bring that value to your money, right? Now, allocated vault storage, where a company warehouses and protects your gold, has become increasingly more popular in the last 10 years. You can also look into a gold or silver IRA if you own a self-directed IRA program. Another popular route you could take is the route that Warren Buffett has been going, which is investing in gold and silver mining companies, okay? That way you are earning based on the company pulling gold and silver and platinum out of the earth and not the actual physical gold itself. The largest gold miner in the world, for instance, is Newmont Corporation, which trades on the New York Stock Exchange. Now, one of the advantages of Newmont is they have a good track record and they've paid a healthy dividend over the years, as well as being one of the top people in the gold arena, right? However, one of the downsides is that they've been around for a long time, right? So they've kind of already gone through that rise in the stock price. So we might want to look at some companies that still have a lot of upside potential. Now, one group that I've owned in the past was Hecla Mining in Idaho. They mostly conduct silver mining operations, and silver can be a great way to hedge against inflation as well, while securing a gain over time. But sticking with the gold companies, there is one that I want to focus on, and it is based in Canada. It trades on the Canadian Stock Exchange under the ticker BLLG. It's also available to U.S. investors on the New York Stock Exchange under the symbol BLAGF. Now, the name of this particular company is Blue Lagoon Resources. Now, to get a mining operation up and fully permitted takes many, many years and millions of dollars. But Blue Lagoon has gone through this process, and with its flagship project, it only has to complete a few more things so that they can start mining and have an incredible 2021, which is pretty exciting, right? Because their stock has a lot of upside potential still. They will begin their first major drilling program in January of 2021. So just around the corner, right? Like a month from now. Now, these guys are in a unique position in that they have $6 million in the bank, and as of right now, only carry around $200,000 of corporate debt. So they have very healthy books and the ability to fund this project over time. Now, recently, their lead geologist used CAD technology along with sampling to conduct exploration efforts in the different projects that they own on their property. According to company filings, Dome Mountain Project has 15 high-grade veins of gold. So their geologist has already found these gold veins. In fact, in an interview, the CEO, Rana Vig, did say that he was able to purchase the Dome Mountain mine for $27 million, even though the previous owner had spent $68 million bringing the mine up to code and making it operational. So great CEO with good negotiating instincts, right? Now, the market cap on this company is still well below the $68 million range. This same CEO, Rana Vig, took two companies from startup to market with significant success. You can search his name. He's now jumped into the gold mining space because he sees an incredible opportunity as the world seems to be looking for security and physical value backing money versus fiat currency and issuing endless amounts of debt. Again, you can check them out on the U.S. exchanges by searching the ticker symbol BLAGF. Okay, now they could be a great opportunity based on what I've read and still having lots of upside potential. I think the biggest advantage is the stock price is more approachable than even the price of one gold coin, which is around $1,840. So the barrier to entry is obtainable for investors at all starting points. So if you're not super rich, you still have a chance to get in. If you do have money, you still have a chance to get in. It's just a great opportunity, right? Okay, so another area you might want to look at if you're unable to buy gold at $1,840 an ounce would be silver dollars, which as of this video are around $27 to $28 a coin. Now, I wanted to show you some of the different coins that I have right now. I'll just show you a few. So this right here, if you can see that, is the Indian head and also the eagle. These are what are called silver rounds. Here's another one that I really like in my collection. It's a little bit more detailed, but it, again, it's an eagle and also the Liberty Bell, where our country got going, right? Out there in Philadelphia. And then also have one of these silver rectangular coins, right? That's the American flag. As you can tell, I love the American flag, right? So now you'll want to work with a reputable online company or a gold, silver, or coin shop in your local area. For beginners, I would suggest looking into these silver rounds, okay? You're just going to pay the price and not a premium markup. Now, when I went in, they did try to talk me into something called Morgan silver dollars, and they're beautiful, right? These are high quality silver, but they're more of a collector's item than what I was looking for. I just wanted the silver that I could hold and allow it to appreciate over time. But they are cool looking, right? So don't get roped into paying more for a collector's coin when what you're really after is just silver as a way of protecting the value of your money and hedging against inflation. So to wrap up, 2021 could be a really hard year for a lot of people. It could have a lot of ups and downs, or it could be a great recovery year. Much of the success of the economy is really out of your hands and out of mine. However, we can control our own economy by educating ourselves and looking for opportunities with upside potential that are also protected against big swing losses and things that are out of our control, right? Like someone would have to really come after me to get these coins, right? So I control that. I have that in my possession. Now, they say that success leaves clues, and the track record of owning precious metals over time has been a great way of protecting and growing people's money, right? However, Warren Buffett is showing that owning gold mining stocks or silver stocks has potentially bigger upside and a lower barrier to entry for those that want to potentially get in on the next hot sector in 2021. Hey, I want to thank you for joining me today on this video. I hope you found value. Go check out the companies that I talked about, Blue Lagoon Resource. You can also check into Newmont. You could also check into getting some of these silver dollars in your local area. I wish to remind you that you are amazing. I appreciate you being in my community, and I'll see you on the next video.